their dominant structure motifs. Many fibrous proteins such as those of skin, bone, tendons function as structural materials, and others such as muscle and ciliary proteins have motif or motile functions. So first of all, we will see the example of fibrous protein, that is alpha keratin. Keratin is a mechanically durable and chemically unreactive protein that occur in higher animals, and it is the principal component of their body, of their horny epidermal layer, and comprising 85% of total cellular proteins. They also present in related appendages such as hair, nails, and feathers. Okay, and keratins have been classified either as alpha keratins, which occur in mammals, or beta keratins, which occur in birds and reptiles. The basic structural unit of alpha keratin is a four-stranded double helices, four-stranded structure called a protofibrin, which consists of two double helices. And these protofibrils are then arrayed in a larger structure called a microfibril, which consists of eight protofibrils, and they associated to form either hollow circle or a hollow square. Microfibrils are then cross-linked by disulfide bonds, and the number of disulfide bonds determine the rigidity of the fiber. So you can see here the structural units of alpha keratin: two double helices form protofibrils, and eight protofibrils form microfibrils, and this microfibril is the structural unit of alpha keratin, and their rigidity is determined by the number of disulfide bonds. Keratins with few disulfide bond links such as found in wool are soft and flexible and stretch easily, and keratins with many disulfide bonds such as in beaks and claw are hard, rigid and inflexible. And the springiness of hair and wool fiber is consequence of the coil tendency to untwist when stretched and to recover its original conformation when the external force is relaxed. Okay, and this is all about the structure of alpha keratins. Then next one example is collagen. Collagen, it occurs in all multicellular animals and is the most abundant proteins of vertebrates. It is an extracellular protein that is organized into insoluble form, fibers of great tensile strength. It is a rod-shaped molecule of about 3000 angstrom long and 15 angstrom in diameter, and it contains three helical polypeptide chain, each nearly 1000 residues long, and the structural unit of this collagen is known as tropocollagen. The amino acid sequence of collagen is very regular. Nearly every third amino acid residue is glycine. It is generally a repeating tripeptide unit of glycine X for any amino acid, proline, or glycine X hydroxyproline. Hydroxyproline confers stability on collagen probably through intramolecular hydrogen bonds, that means the hydrogen bonds within the same collagen molecule. It contains covalently attached collagen also contains covalently attached carbohydrates in amount that range from 0.4% to 12% by weight, and collagen are insoluble in solvents, and it can also cross-linked by lysinol or leucine, unusual amino acid linkage. Actually, lysine present in one polypeptide chain bonded with lysine present to adjacent polypeptide chain, and there is formation of unusual amino acid, that is lysinol or leucine. And the degree of this cross-linking of collagen increases with the age of the animal. Okay, you can see here or imagine the structure of collagen. The structure is just rope-like structure in which three helices are wound around to each other like this, and proline is present in this. Every third residue is glycine, and proline is also present here because of their rigidity, and glycine is present in there because of their small size. Then third one example of fibrous protein is elastin. Elastin connective tissue contains the fibrous protein elastin, which resembles their structure like collagen, and the polypeptide subunit of elastin fibrin is tropoelastin, and it contains 800 amino acids, and it is like collagen rich in glycine, but another amino acid is here alanine. They have many lysine but few proline residue, and it forms a special type of helix that is differing from alpha helix and spina as well as also different from collagen helix. The results containing lysine residue form covalent crosslinks and four lysine side chains come together and converted into desmosine. Four lysine residues from the polypeptide chain come together and there is formation of desmosine. And lysine and non-leucine also occur in the elastin. These non-standard amino acids are capable of joining tropoelastin chains that can be stretched reversibly in all directions. So this is the lysine and non-leucine cross-linking that is present in elastin. So these are the example of fibrous proteins.